Margate lifeboat crew were standing by in their favourite pub, playing a quiet game of darts, when I called them to the boathouse on Thursday, May the 30th. They thought it was just an ordinary lunch, perhaps the search for another Jerry Airman who had been shot down in the sea. We had picked up several as it was. I asked them if they would take the boat to Dunkirk to out rescue our boys. That was a shock to them, but they all volunteered without a murmur. I rushed home to tell their wives to get some food, and then we were off. Margate was a pretty dead town then. More than half the residents had evacuated. But when we got to Dunkirk, it was a bit different. With shells bursting and fires raging, it was like hell. Our first job all through that night was to take aboard wounded from La Pam Hospital, which was being shelled, and transfer them to a destroyer. Some were floated out to us on rafts, and others carried with soldiers who waded through the water, holding them over their heads. On Friday, we was ferrying troops off to the different ships, when I heard a squeaking in the boat, and I thought it was the engine. And hoping was nothing was going to happen to our engine over there. So we searched the boat all round, and we found that there was a French soldier had got a guinea pig under his tunic, and this was the making the noise.